Grubby.
Huh? Oh, hi, Grubby. What's going on?
Well, Teddy, I'm just a little confused.
Confused about what?
About bears.
You are?
Yeah, I thought that bears were bears. But now I'm hearing that some bears are bears, and other bears aren't bears.
Oh, I see what you mean.
Oh, good. Then you can clear it all up.
Well, I don't know if I can do that or not. Sometimes bears don't even know whether or not they're bears.
Really?
Yes.
Looks just the same when he is upside down.
A koala's nose is sensitive, just like his furry ears.
A koala recognizes everything he smells or hears.
A koala is a slow and a cuddly ball of fuzz, but he says he isn't lazy, he is only slow because
he just likes to be deliberate about everything he does.
And so 20 minutes later, he will still be where he was. Now who wouldn't love a koala? Oh, who wouldn't love a koala?
A koala isn't sure whether he's a teddy bear.
Or is he some sort of panda?
Does anybody care?
Or is he just a marsupial in fuzzy underwear?
How much more of this confusion can a poor koala bear?
A koala can be found hanging by his pointy toes and intent upon consuming every gum tree leaf that grows.
And sometimes without a warning he will even start to doze. Sorry, Teddy.
Now who wouldn't love a koala? Oh, who wouldn't love a koala?
A koala's nose is soft, a koala's nose is round.
A koala knows exactly who would like him hanging round.
So if you see a koala, tickle him under the arm. Soft.
A koala's nose is round. A koala knows exactly who would like him hanging round. And so please don't be surprised if he should kiss you on the nose. Because how to be a friend is just what each koala knows. So who wouldn't love a koala? Do you know that this koala loves you?
Well, Teddy, is a koala a bear or not?
What do you think a koala is?
I think it's a bear.
No, Grubby. A koala is really a marsupial.
Oh.
Do you know what other kind of animals are from the marsupial family?
Nope.
Well, kangaroos and possums?
How about that?
Thought about a panda? They seem to look at things so very casually. They roll around the ground or lean against a tree. But I have found that they're not really wishy-washy. To pandas, everything is black and white.
No, nothing is ever meaningful to a panda bear. Issues aren't left up in the air. One thing you'll never hear a panda say is I don't care.
To pandas everything is black and white. And pandas think that's just how everyone
so very casually they roll around the ground or lean against a tree. But I have found that they're not really wishy-washy. To them there's everything that's black and white. To them there are no areas that are ever level there. They make a clear distinction between what's night and day. They find it hard believing what others have to say, unless it's written down in black and white. Now you're not gonna tell me that pandas are marsupials too, are you?
No.
Oh, good.
Actually, no one is too sure what kind of animal a panda is, but they're not bears.
Oh, no. Teddy, you're spoiling all my notions about bears.
Oh, well, maybe this song will cheer you up. The Arctic is really a strange place to be,
but polar bears still live there.
And I suppose not known for its hospitality,
but polar bears still live there.
It's windy, it's freezing, and cold as can be.
How can those bears still live there?
Maybe it's because they've learned to keep warm by doing the polar bear polka.
So white that it's hard to stay neat.
And yet those bears keep dancing. They hop and they jump to that same polka beat.
How can those bears keep dancing?
Maybe they have learned the way to keep warm is doing the polar bear polka. Doesn't really matter how warm his fur might be, or if the places he's been past, leave stitches you can see. It doesn't matter if his eyes don't look as good as new. All that really matters is that he still loves you. And he's your teddy bear. He's right there when you need him. He's your teddy bear. He'll go where you will lead him. If you're sick or if you're well, it's always swell having him there. 'Cause he's your teddy bear. Stitches you can see. It doesn't matter if his eyes don't look as good as new. All that really matters is that he still loves you. And he's your teddy bear. Somehow none of your other toys can quite compare. The one you will remember when your hair has turned to gray, then you will say,
confusion is pretty much cleared up, but one bear I'm still not too sure of.
Oh, which one?
You.
Me?
Yep, you. You're an Iliop, right?
Right.
From the far-off land of Galonian?
That's right.
But is an Iliop the same as a bear?
Well, you can call me an Iliop, or you can call me a bear. I really don't care. As long as you call me your friend.
Well, that's good enough for me. My best friend is an Iliop.
An Iliop.
An Iliop is my best friend. My best friend is an Iliop.
An Iliop.
An Iliop is my best friend. 'Cause you can trust an Iliop to do the things that he's supposed to. You can trust an Iliop to do the things he says he'll do. You can trust an Iliop to be your best friend just forever, and he would like it also if you'd be his best friend too. You can trust an Iliop will always have a sense of humor. You can trust an Iliop will always have a sense of pride. You can trust that if somehow he isn't always quite successful, at least you can be sure an Iliop has really tried.
At least you can be sure an Iliop has really tried.
And that's why my best friend is an Iliop.
An Iliop.
An Iliop is my best friend. My best friend is an Iliop.
An Iliop.
An Iliop is my best friend. 'Cause he just has a disposition that is always just the same. He also makes the day seem sunny even though there's pouring rain. If he's ill, an Iliop will probably say he's feeling fine, 'cause there's no chance that you will hear an Iliop.